Start rhinoceros. Open the truss.3dm file located in the demo files. Position Rhino on the left part of your screen. Start Grasshopper by typing Grasshopper into the Rhino command line. And position Grasshopper on the right side of the screen. Open the truss.gh file from Grasshopper located in the same folder as shown above. Display the entire Grasshopper canvas to view the entire code. The Grasshopper definition consists of a matching series of simple trusses along a given desired surface. The basic building block of the definition is one truss with a top and bottom chord, where both chords are divided into segments and their points culled and connected to create lateral bracing. This single truss takes up the second half of the visual algorithm. Select the part of the definition highlighted in green below, and turn the definition on to see the truss. To turn definitions or components on or off, press the spacebar to bring up the radial menu. The head icon with and without blindfolds will turn your components on and off. Display the top view in Rhino. The truss is placed along a surface by taking the surface and dividing it into parallel segments. Navigate to the View Contours in Grasshopper. Select the component and see the contours, the upper truss chords highlighted in Rhino. Navigate to the View Beams in Grasshopper. Select the component and see the curves, lower truss chords, highlighted in Rhino. Navigate to the View Columns in Grasshopper and see how the Grasshopper components are connected to ARCHICAD elements. The parallel curves of the upper and lower chords are fed into ARCHICAD beams, and the lateral bracing defines ARCHICAD columns. If you select the line components in this view, you can see the Grasshopper geometry highlighted in Rhino that defines the ARCHICAD columns. The Grasshopper line component uses a start and end point as input, just as the ARCHICAD column does. Open ARCHICAD by double-clicking its icon on the desktop. Position the ARCHICAD application window on the right side of the screen. Select the Grasshopper connection option from the Design, Design Extras menu to display the Grasshopper dialog. Click the Start Connection button to start the Grasshopper ARCHICAD Live connection. The model appears in the 3D window of ARCHICAD. Open the One Columns Element Schedule. Once the model is synchronized in ARCHICAD, we were able to get crucial schedule type information about the truss. The ARCHICAD model inherits the update as well. The Rhino tutorial file contains two different surfaces in Rhino, one simpler and one that is more organically shaped. To illustrate the versatility of the definition, we could go back to the beginning of the algorithm and decide that we would like to apply this system of flat trusses to the other surface. Display the surface view in Grasshopper. Right-click on the surface component and choose Set New Surface to pick the second, tablecloth-like, surface pre-modeled in the Rhino file. Once the definition contains the new surface information, the trusses populate this geometry right away, adapting to the different design criteria. The ARCHICAD model inherits the update as well. We could also change the distance between the chords by moving the number slider at any point during the design process. Go to the Contours view in Grasshopper and change the number slider to 11. The ARCHICAD model reflects those changes instantly.